All right. We are just around the corner right now. I just got like a little glimpse of the launch pad. I can see it right here in front of me. Oh, wow. It's right there.
Oh my goodness.
All right. We are literally like maybe 300 feet away from the Lucy spacecraft on the Atlas V rocket. From what I understand, I think we're going to be actually taking an elevator up to the top of this launch, or the VIF, the Vertical Integration Facility, to see Lucy up close. And we are some of the last people to be seeing Lucy before she blasts off into space. It's a long mission ahead. And yeah, super, super thrilled to share this moment with you and take you along for the ride. How's it going? So nice to meet you.
It's going good. Good to meet you as well.
Thanks so much for taking us around. This is incredible.
This is insane.
Oh my gosh.
I mean, isn't that just that's cool? I mean, this rocket is massive.
Yep. Yeah, the scale of it. I mean, 200 feet tall. Yeah. I'm joined today by Isaac and Danya, and we are standing directly in front of the Lucy spacecraft atop an Atlas V rocket. We were just talking on the way up about the scale of this thing. It's really pretty impressive to just take a step back and appreciate the sheer magnitude and scale of this rocket. So can you tell us a bit more about the dimensions of this thing and kind of what is all powering Lucy on its journey out to the Trojans?
Yeah, so Lucy's actually right now sitting on our 401 Atlas V configuration. Fully stacked to the top of the payload fairing. It's about 190 feet tall. So we have the entire vehicle right now sitting on our mobile launch platform, 1.3 million pound steel structure. We have our Atlas booster, our single engine Centaur, and then the Lucy spacecraft on top of that.
And the Lucy spacecraft, it's not a small spacecraft itself. It's pretty large as well,
no.
Right? Tom?
No, it's not a small spacecraft. It's about the size of a standard car. It weighs 3,300 pounds. And half of that is the fuel. And so, I want to talk a little bit about the solar rays.
Yeah,
so
that's what's interesting.
With the solar rays stowed, they're about 4 inches thick. But when they're deployed, they're 7.2 meters in diameter. So if you were to take the spacecraft with the solar rays deployed and tip it on its side, it'd be as tall as a four-story building.
And why do the solar panels need to be that massive? They're specifically designed for this mission for this exact reason, too.
Yes, so Lucy is going to travel 4 billion miles through its journey, its 12 years journey. And it's traveling far from the sun. As a matter of fact, it's going to be the farthest spacecraft traveling on solar power. And so that's why we need massive solar rays.
And so, I mean, it's a long journey ahead, 12-year-long mission, but there's already been quite a journey on the back end here just to get us prepared. Can you walk us through, I guess, the past, like, you know, 14 months during the pandemic here? Well, how's
quite
it been?
Quite exciting. So we actually started spacecraft integration and testing in July of 2020. Think about it, 14 months to fully integrate the spacecraft and the payload, the instrument, during a pandemic, testing it through an entire environmental test campaign, which simulates space, which gives us confidence that it's going to survive the full mission.
That's amazing. Yeah, and then also just the journey to get the spacecraft from all its individual parts assembled on the C-17 that you got to ride with, and then to here. I mean, what's been the process like on the ground at KSC?
Yeah, so once we landed, we had about 7 weeks in which we reintegrated hardware, like the high gain antenna, and updated flight software, and did functional testing to verify that we didn't break anything during shipment.
It's important.
And then we fueled the spacecraft and did our final on-pad functional. And the spacecraft is currently powered up, and we're monitoring it state of health 24/7 through launch.
And then what is it going to be like the day of the launch as well, kind of getting the spacecraft ready, really long before sunrise even, to get it ready to...
Yeah, so we'll, our crew will actually be coming in at 10 o'clock the night before for our... yes, exactly. For our pre-launch securing. So we'll go through all of the final closeouts at the pad, our final pad preps, pulling the cover over the flame bucket where the exhaust will go for launch, doing all our final preps, and then clearing the pad at roughly 2:30 in the morning, so they can we can go into cryogenic tanking. And then at liftoff, 860,000 pounds of thrust at sea level will take Lucy on its journey.
And then we're on our way. I mean, it's a 12-year-long journey, and we were just talking about this on the way up. Yeah. It's super exciting, obviously, a long mission ahead, a lot of really cool discoveries waiting for us out there. But at the same time, I mean, a little bit of sadness here, because this is the last time that we're going to be this close. Humans are going to be this close to the Lucy spacecraft.
It is. I mean, as the project manager, right, my tenure on Lucy is going to be ending soon. So it is a little sad, but it's also exciting. It's exciting, and I will be waiting with bated breath as we encounter those Trojans. I know what we think we're going to find, but I'm excited for the new discoveries, the unexpected. That's what I'm looking forward to. And we'll be following this mission and waiting for it to rewrite our science books.
Yeah, and obviously not your first rodeo. You've sent many missions up to space. What, I mean, keeps it exciting? What keeps you coming back every single time to launch another mission up on the Atlas V?
It's something where you'd think it would get routine and benign, and it's just every mission, every launch, that final countdown, if you're not getting butterflies, then you're in the wrong business.
I mean, the view alone up here, just checking out before, I mean, it's exciting, kind of just taking it all in and just
enjoy what you see and take pride in all the hard work that folks, everyone, have done to contribute to the success of this mission.
It takes thousands and thousands of people to get us to where we are today, from all the different teams, all the different organizations. And on top of that, it's something that beyond those that directly contributed, it's something, a mission that as special as this, that really everyone is able to share a part of and everyone's able to follow for its entire journey. So it's something where even people at home can experience the launch, experience the mission, and follow along with it. It's really special.
Wishing you guys the best of luck, and I want to thank both of you for taking some time out of your incredibly busy schedules here. You know, we're just hours, I guess, away over the next couple days here from Lucy blasting off away from us. So thank you both. Congratulations on all that's happened so far, and best of luck over the next 12 years on this long journey.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.